ערב טוב חברים יקרים, אנחנו בשעה טובה מתחילים היום בשיעור השני שלנו בעצם, ענייני ראש השנה, ואני מקווה שיהיה לכם מקום לשבת, קחו מי שצריך להביא כיסא, שיביא כיסא בחוץ. השיעור הזה שלנו היום אחד מהחשובים ביותר, הוא מוקדש לעילוי נשמת יוסף בן רחמים ורונן בן אהובה. ומי עוד? ולפעת כל המוסר, וכל מי שתזכיר אותו בפיכם. ברוך אתו אדוני, אלוהינו מלאכו עלום, שהכל נהיה בדברו. נשאלת השאלה, יאללה, בכבוד. נשאלת השאלה, למה דווקא ראש השנה נבחר שהוא יהיה יום הדין? למה לא פסח? אולי חנוכה? אולי שבועות? למה דווקא ראש השנה?
גם בריאתו של העולם.
מה יש ביום הזה? מה?
גם בריאתו של העולם.
אז נברא העולם, אז מה?
עכשיו אני יכול להביא כיבוד.
אז נברא העולם. So, we ask a question, why... Amen. Why was this day, Rosh Hashanah, was chosen as a judgment day? Why not Passover? Why not Shavuot? למה Rosh Hashanah? What's the reason?
It's the time.
A time? אז זה time. מה יש בטעם? מה יש בזמן הזה?
מה?
מה?
מה לך? Because if you look now, the Zodiac,
כן, מה מיוחד? מה מיוחד בזמן הזה?
זה
אוקיי, אדם נוצר, נכון, אדם נוצר, מה זה אומר? בראש השנה ברוך כתוב, השלים הקודש ברוך כל מעשה בראשית, השם finalized all his creation. שאותו יום שישי, it was a Friday, שבו נברא האדם, ראש השנה, היה דברי רבי אליעזר שאומר, בראש השנה נברא העולם, and that happens in ראש השנה. Oh, יפה. Indeed, that's my next one. Actually, it's from here. אומר הקדוש ברוך הוא, כתוב ככה, שני טעמים עיקריים נקבע ראש השנה ליום הדין. הטעם אחד, לפי שביום זה נגמרה בריאתו, and Hashem has planned to run the world under the measurement, under the midah called din, judgment. This is why, תחילת ראש השנה ליום הדין. הטעם השני, אמרנו כבר, שעמד האדם הראשון בדין, ישב בתשובה ונמחל לו. Because Adam was created, and he did the big mistake. We follow the hours, we'll see what happened exactly that day. Hata, v'yatza bedimos, he has seen. Judgment was on the table. V'ma shekara achar kach, he did teshuva, and Hashem mahal lo, Hashem forgive them. Hashem, you mark this day as a day of judgment, a day that you do teshuva, and a day that I forgive. מה עוד? בתשרי נולדו האבות. A forefather born on תשרי, the month of תשרי. ראש השנה, נפקדו שרה חבר הנה, three of our matriarchs, right? שרה, רחל וחנה, they were childless, והשם ברך אותם שנפקדו. They become pregnant. ביום הזה, that day, ראש השנה, יוסף אבינו. Get out of the jail. He was there for how many years?
12
שנה. ואורו התחיל לזורח. So someone asked me the other day, Rabbi, you call them a tzaddik, נכון? Tzaddik is someone that prays, someone that do tefillot. How you could do anything in the jail? The jail is a disgusting place, especially in those days. Makom magil. You know, people, you know, doing their thing, private things there. You can't even say Hashem's name over there. Tzaddik based on what? Is it tefillah? So, but it's even worse. It's even worse, underground. There is no air. 12 years. Not one day. Not 2 days. Not 1 year. 12 years. What tefillah did they? How can be... Hazak v'osh. So... I'm going to tell you a chidush today. Holy chidush. I don't think you ever heard that before. So I was wondering... I read it a long time ago, and the other guy that asked me, I remember the answer. תן לו, רוצה להרים לך, לכבד אותך. שהוא צריך לקחת פרגיות גם, הלו, הוא מחכה גם לפרגיות. סליחה שאני צריך להגיד את זה בווידאו, סורי. דעיניים, תקח פרגיות, לא לקחת לספרן. אוקיי. You're right. There's only few people in the Tanakh that called and named Tzaddik. One of them is not even Jewish. Okay? Noah is Tzaddik. Iyov, Job, is not Jewish, said Tzaddik. But about Yosef, he said Tzaddik.
Because it suppressed his Yitzhara.
Okay.
Suppress your...
So he said, not necessarily have to be with Tfilot.
It should have, but it's not necessary to be Tzaddik. Because
okay.
Otherwise,
everybody else
is Abraham is
Shachrit,
Isaac is
Mintadit,
they're not
Tzaddik. You know, you can be Tzaddik even if you're not being called Tzaddik by Hashem. There are many Tzaddikim in the Tanakh, Yeshaya, Yirmiyah, all the big names. But let me tell you, even when Hashem calls someone Tzaddik, people can challenge it. Noah, Hashem called them Tzaddik. What they say, Rashi said, Tzaddik in his generation. If he lived in the time as well, I'm more not Tzaddik. But Hashem said Tzaddik. Why are you doing this comparison for? Mm-hmm. This is Jewish, Baruch Hashem. Always have something to argue about. Now, back to our question. I saw a beautiful explanation. It says that when Potiphar put him in jail, nachon? He has to kill him. Why didn't he kill him? If he messed with his wife, he's supposed to chop his head off. Why didn't
he
kill him?
He knew that it's not true.
He knew. How did he know?
Put the fire.
Right, yeah. Right. So you said that before. Because she told him, you see what happened to you now? That's what he did to me. And he says, this is the spot where this is his seed. His semen, right? This is the leftover from what he did to me. Tried to did to me. So, huh? That's what Yosef did? He was in shock. He loved him very much. And he knew that it's not his character. It's not something he would do. So he called the Hartumim. Said, there are scientists.
Mesilas Nefesh.
Mesilas Nefesh, Baruch Hashem. Tizkei lebanim talmidei hachamim. Kol ha-yoshvim po, Mezrat Hashem. So what happened was, listen to this, what happened was, he called the scientists, they were great in time. Those days, they were unbelievable. They knew astrology, they knew medicine. Today, we don't know. Today, we don't know how they do the mummification process. How they do it? How they preserve bodies, and such. I mean. Limited sources, but yet they knew. For another discussion. Yeah, mummification. So, they didn't know. Okay, so he called them and said, there's a simple test. What's the test? What she did, she put an eggshell. Not eggshell, the egg, not the yolk, just the whiter. Now, it looks the same, and he doesn't know. He had suspicions. So he called them. And they did a very simple test. You put it on the fire. If it's melted, it's a semen.
You put the egg white on the fire?
Whatever, she gave him a sheet, and he said, this is his, what he did. Okay. Now they put it on the fire.
On the pan.
And it becomes scrambled eggs, it's eggs. And it becomes scrambled eggs. Now he's looking at the magician and says, that's not real. So he's looking at them. He's looking at his wife. It's going to be a big embarrassment. she was one of the most beautiful people, women in that that generation, maybe even. You know, he was Sara Tabahim. He wasn't a chef. He was the head of the he was the executioner. That's what he's doing. Anyways, so now he's debating with himself. I'm going to lose a great CEO. This guy is going to run my house. So what he did, he put him in jail. He felt bad. And he put him in jail. So he didn't want to embarrass his wife. But on the other hand, he didn't want to lose him as a good employee. So what did he do? During the day, you know, you can take slaves to do your jobs, like they're doing even today, cleaning roads, whatever. Took him to job, and during the night, he went back. So only in morning, only during the night, he was there. That's what happened. So wherever he's at, it was a clean place. He could daven, he could pray to Hashem, he could do whatever.
During the day, he wasn't in jail?
Yeah.
Wow, that's a great
chiddush. It's a good
chiddush, huh? Who brings that?
I think I saw that in Mamloes, maybe. I think.
Maybe Mamloes.
I don't know. It's not necessarily. You know, even for 1 week, you need to shave. 1 week you need to change. Even if you stay in jail, such a place, it stinks. You can be there for 1 hour. It stinks. I went one time to one's car. Someone took me from shul home. It takes 5 minutes. And my wife asked me if I smoked. Did you start smoking? I said, I'm not. What's smoking? Because this guy is smoking in the car. 5 minutes! And it sticks to you. Anyways. Borosh Hashanah, this tzaddik comes out. So Yosef, after so much suffering, started to shine. It's a time, mesugal. It's a time that is capable. We call it this zemanim, times during during the year, that if you catch the right timing, you can do great things with your life. So take, for example, Bilam. He knew when Hashem is getting upset, getting angry, okay? The exact timing. That's what he knew. That's the whole secret he knew. There's times, that's the best time to pray. It's the best time. There's a window that's open. It's called Sh'at Ratzon, times of a will. So when is the times of a will? Time of will is a time that you can ask from Hashem everything you need. So Sh'at Ratzon, when you can be Sh'at Ratzon? The times when you do a mitzvah. When you do a mitzvah, Hafetz Chaim wrote, this is a time that you can ask for Hashem everything you want.
What time?
When you do mitzvah.
No.
This is why when women, when the light kindles, they do mitzvah and then they ask for Hashem all they want. Okay? Based on that knowledge. It's called Sha'at Ratzon. There's during the, sometimes things happen in the world and it's established in the calendar and it stays there forever. For example, there's a time in the year that whatever you do, you succeed. If you do, if you have a judgment against non-Jew, take him to that month. What month is it? Adar. Right? Postpone it to Adar. Adar, the mazel of Israel is up. On the contrary, you have Av. Av, the mazel is down.
The opposite.
The opposite. So if you know the time, you're going to be very careful. I have a grandpa, Rabbi Yosef Silvani. I saw him all my life, either on his way to shul or come back from shul, or when I see him at home, he's either studying or falling asleep like that. I took pictures. People won't believe me. He's either studying or falling asleep with his book. Everything you know by heart. If I say everything you know by heart, you won't believe me, but I tell you to which extent. We do targum. You know, when you read the Torah, the Yemenite, you read Pasuk, and there's a Targum.
Targum.
All Yemenite. He knew all the Targum for the whole חמישה חומשי תורה by heart. You tell him פסוק, he will tell you the תרגום. How do I know? Because I came to test for him and he doesn't have a book. He will correct me on his way to make coffee, coming back. We don't need a book. And I'm not talking about the word. If it's with kamatz or with pata. Nochal lehan kolohon. This is something unbelievable. But that's what they know. They didn't deal with anything else, just Torah. So that's what they know. You know Rabbi Sinmani that comes here every year? This is his son. So, Baruch Hashem, there is a time in the year, if you know to catch the right timing, l'sha'at ratzon, you'll get it. As the King David says, va'ani tefilati, ayat ratzon. Elohim berov hasdecha, aneni be'emet ishaecha. Even King David knew. Sh'at ratzon, prayer.
Yeah.
Even if someone gets sick, do davening at home when the tzibur is in the shul, the same timing. Because your tefillah will go up with their tefillah. Okay. On Rosh Hashanah, also, ראש השנה בטלה עבודת אבותינו במצרים ובא להם רשות גאולתם. The Israelites were redeemed from their hardship in Egypt on Rosh Hashanah. See how many great things happen on Rosh Hashanah. So you don't want to rest this day for mundane talking. Shmuzim. It's a day you can ask for everything you need from Hashem. Health, children, you name it. The list is very long. But what happened with Adam? בראש השנה, אדם was created. הכיצד? שעה ראשונה, first hour, עלה במחשבה. Hashem had the plan. Second, he consulted with the angels. Third, he put together the dust. Fourth, he put moist. The fifth, he had the רקמו. He put the skin and all that. בשישית, עשהו גולם. עמידו רגליו. Make him stand. And the seventh hour, he put neshama in him. In the eighth hour, he put him in Gan Eden. In the ninth hour, he commanded them, everything is for you except this tree. The tree of da'at, of knowledge. And the ninth hour, he commanded them. And the tenth hour, he transgressed this law. He broke it, broke the law. He ate from the tree. On the 11th hour, he was judged. On the 12th, he did teshuvah, and Hashem forgive him. And then he told them, you mark this day for the generation after. כשם שנכנסת לפני בדין ביום הזה ויצאת בדימוס, כך עתידים בניך להיות נכנסים לפני בדין ביום הזה ויוצאים לפני בדימוס. He says, you mark such a special day. Same as you, who got off the hook. With the teshuvah you did, I'll do the same thing to your children. Your descendants.
It's
a part of the sin. No. 130 years, he accepted upon himself suffering, and he separated himself from his wife, from Chava.
נכון, אבל מיד, באופן מיידי, הוא לא כתוב חטאתי כמו שדוד המלך.
לא צריך שיהיה כתוב. לא צריך שיהיה כתוב. מספיק שהמדרש אומר לי שהוא עשה תשובה.
אוקיי, אז למה הוא לא נשאר בגן עדן?
סליחה?
למה הוא לא נשאר בגן עדן?
מפני שגן עדן זה מתאים רק למישהו שאין לו חטאים בכלל.
למה? אבל הוא שינה את המצב שלו, הוא אמר חטאתי, הוא התחרד. זהו, נמחק העוון.
That's a big mistake. שהרבה טועים בזה. למה? הרבה חושבים שאדם עשה תשובה, עכשיו לא יהיה לו עונש. Many people think that when they do תשובה, they have no more punishment. Big mistake. למה? How do I know that? It's very simple Gemara. The Talmud says, כל האומר, הקודש ברוך הוא, ותרן, יוותרו בני מעב. That Hashem will let go. Hashem will let go your stomach. You know, it's very extreme to say it, but it means that don't you think that Hashem is so easy? You bribe him with teshuvah and let go. Okay, I forgive you. You forgive you means that the punishment that will come will be very, very much, much less than it was supposed to be.
שגם הוא נהנש, וגם האדמה נהנשה בבור, וגם האישה נהנשה, בעצם תלדי בנים. כל המציאות השתנתה בעולם.
נכון, אבל האדם הראשון, אם השם היה צריך להעניש אותו לגמרי, היה צריך להשמיד אותו. הוא לא השמיד אותו, השאיר אותו בחיים. האדם עושים תיקון למצב שהוא גרם, הוא וחווה. הייתה מחשבה כשברור, בלי יצר הרע. יצר הרע was separate, was out. כשהם קיבלו את דברי היצר רע שזה הנחש, הוא נכנס בתוכו. ואז הוא שלט בו, עכשיו אתה תתמודד איתו, זה התיקון שלך. אתה מבין? כי הגן עדן שהשם שם אותו, איפה הגן עדן הזה היה? Where was it this heaven? Where was it? איפה? בשמיים? איפה זה? איפה זה? In תל אביב? In רמת גן? Where is it?
לא, הגן עדן היה המציאות של העולם.
בניש חי, he says where the גן עדן.
יש לוקיישן. נהר, חידקל, זה, יש לוקיישן.
מעבר לדלת.
הא? It's somewhere over the rainbow. It's somewhere in Eretz Yisrael, I think, and it's covered from our eyes, which means it's there. You can't find it on GPS. You can't find it on Google Map. It's something like that. Yeah, you know, when Hashem wants to cover something from you, it's going to be here. Pen is here, here, and you're looking for the pen. Where's the pen? Where's the pen? עד שלא ניתנה רשות לעין לראות, לא תראה. Till there is no permission to eye to see, you won't see. How many times it happens to you? It's right here, it's right here. You don't see it. You don't see it. See with Hagar. Hagar was in the desert, and all of a sudden she saw the well. When Hashem created well? No. Hashem just opened her eyes. The will was there all the time. רק לא ניתנה רשות לעין. She didn't give permission to the eye to see. For reasons. I don't know what was the reason. So, going back to what we said, this is such a special day. It's 2 days that you want to use it wisely. But berachot, I'll get to it in a minute. And when we do it this day, and so forth and so on. So let me just stop here and go to the special things that we do during Chag Rosh Hashanah, the day of Rosh Hashanah.
אתה אומר שבן אדם צריך לבקש וזה זמן עת רצון, אבל יש כל כך הרבה דברים שאפשר וצריך לעשות, אז למה זה נותן יותר חשיבות?
אוקיי, so Menashe is asking what's be the priority. What's the priority? I think after we read a few halachot, you'll know what's the...
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
What's the significance of Rosh Hashanah in the time of Mashiach? Because there's no teshuvah in
it. Right. Some of the holidays will continue, and some will not continue. For example, it says that Yom Kippur... Huh? Won't.
Purim, Chanukah,
Tishuvah... The Mefarshim debating why we need Yom Kippur. Because they say, Ki Yom Kippur is going to stay. Okay. Why? What do you need teshuvah for?
Exactly.
Because Hashem will shecht the Yetzer Hara, the evil inclination. Kamayim la'am echasim, the whole world will know the truth. And whoever will survive, you know, because we're saying there's two-thirds of the world will destroy. And whoever survived is whoever kept Torah, Mitzvot, and Din Chasadim, and non-Jews also, that they kept the seven universal laws. To do what? There's no Yetzer Hara. So why do I still need Yom Kippur? Or Rosh Hashanah, as you say. Pray for what? So I saw an explanation that says, it's not going to be the same Yom Kippur. It's going to be a day when you're elevating your neshama even higher. With special prayers and special singing or whatever, something like that. Rambam already answered that question. And he said, Lo neda ad sheyavo. Meaning, we don't know. It's saying like, I don't want to hear any speculation because we won't know until Mashiach comes. Anything before that, it's speculation. We don't really know. And it's true. You see so many Mefarshim, this would happen, that would happen, this will keep, they will not keep. We don't know. Let Mashiach come and fix this. Otherwise, we don't really know. That's what the Rambam says. When I talk Mashiach, nobody really dealt with Hilchot Mashiach. Only Rambam did that. So it's a question that I don't have a clear answer for you. Because there's a different opinion. Okay. It's customary to take a haircut in Erev Rosh Hashanah this year, Sunday. What if I do one, I want to do Friday or Thursday? You can. But the best to do it on the eve of Rosh Hashanah. Jesse, can you turn the light off over there? Sorry. What's the reason? We're busy. Why do you want me to do a haircut and shaving during this busy day? Chvod Yom Tov, for the sake of the Yom Tov. Why doing that at that night, or that day, I'm sorry, is for the sake of Yom Tov? Because you're showing that the purpose of taking haircut and shaving and taking a shower and new clothing is for the sake of Yom Tov. It's kind like of lighting candles before Shabbat. So you can't do it too early. Shabbat is at 8, you can't do it at 4. Because it doesn't show that it's for the sake of Shabbat. It has to be as close as you can, right? So that could be the main reason. There's also what we do, Hatarat Nedarim. And it's something we did. We're going to do tomorrow, Bezrat Hashem, and Sunday we're going to do again. Hatarat Nedarim after the Tefillah.
Tomorrow
is 2 minutes before Shabbat. Why? Because you don't have to do it. I'm just recommending. Why? Because this is the last Shabbat of the year. Yeah. And this is very special things are related to this Shabbat. And you will come to this Shabbat clear from curses and promises and nedarim and everything. So we will nullify these vows and this everything else. And with Hashem, we'll do it. It takes really 2-3 minutes. We do have the short version. And Bezrat Hashem, Yom Rishon, we'll do it again before Rosh Hashanah, before the new year. So before the Shabbat, last Shabbat of the year, and before the new year. Okay. It says in the tractate of Rosh Hashanah Lev, Lamed Ben, 32, that this is the time when Hashem is sitting on his throne, the Kiseh Din, throne of judgment. And it says something very interesting. It says, Sifre Hayim Umetim, the book of the living and the dead are open before him. And I'm asking you a question. The book of the living people, we know, we understand. But the book of the dead, they died already. Why do you need to open them every year? What for?
The interest.
Huh?
The interest.
Interest from what?
From everything that they left, it accumulates constantly.
Right? Exactly. There is a journey, is in that level in the Gan Eden. But the children doing Kaddish for him, and Torah, and Shiore Torah, and blessing. Wow, they're going to elevate him. It says that tzaddikim, righteous people, have no menuha ba'olam hazeh, velo ba'olam haba. Have no rest, not in this world, not in the next world. Not in this world, I understand. Why is it said they have no rest in the next world also? Because you elevate them. They go, they take the bag, they sit down, they study Torah. And all of a sudden, what happened? You're moving up. What? Hey, your son did Kaddish. I just came yesterday. Okay, they move you. They don't have menuha, but it's good. It's good. They want to be elevated. They want to be as close as it can to the Shekhinah, the light that comes from Hashem. So, obviously, someone that's smart, he leaves children that be able to say Kaddish for him. Shiurei Torah. Those that doesn't have should dedicate some money for people to help them with that. Okay. I mean, for example, you probably noticed that Tzurel is doing Kaddish, right? So there is, you notice that? So there's a woman that nobody says Kaddish for her. Her son is one of my students, he's a doctor. Yeah, you probably saw him here on Wednesdays. And he's not capable to do it for a variety of reasons. Doesn't matter. So, who's doing Kaddish for your mom? Nobody. So we took responsibility to help and I'm Mochel, and Baya, it's a great mitzvah. No, you don't agree with me? Someone now is saying Kaddish for his mom. She just passed away a few months ago. Yeah. And also this Torah class is, I forgot to say, dedicated to her. It's Esther but Malka Hannah. Okay. So this is why the book of the dead are also open. To do the Heshbon, to do the calculation, is it's also customary to go.
Huh? The dead are being judged also.
Absolutely. We said that. Right? It's customary to go in Rosh Hashanah to Beit HaKevavot, to the cemetery. And those who go there should not ask from forgiveness, not forgiveness, not pray to those who bury there. Doesn't matter which one is buried there. By the way, but you can ask the neshama of the tzaddik to be shaliach for you, to be your agent. It's no bayah. But not to pray for him. It's called Avodah Zarah. It's one of the reasons that Hashem hide the burial site of Moshe Rabbeinu. Right? Because they're going to make him Avodah Zarah. Imagine to yourself there's a place in Israel Moshe Rabbeinu is buried. Everybody, people will live there. Mazel. This is the only guy who speaks with Hashem. It's one of the reasons. You won't become Avodah Zarah. Okay, so any questions? I want to move on to something very, maybe in the last 10 minutes, something that we're going to do, Bezrat Hashem, the next two nights. And it's important to know. Also, it's important to know the order of the food that you should eat first, right? And where it comes from, what's the source of it? So I have plenty of fruit here on the table. I have dates, and I have figs, and I have olives, and I have pomegranates. Which one I should eat first? Huh? Why Zayit? True, why Zayit? Huh? There's a very simple rule. The Torah mentions seven species that the land of Israel was praised with, was blessed with, okay? And it's called, it's come from the Pasuk, it's derived from the Pasuk, Eretz Chita, U'Se'ora, V'Gefen, V'Te'ena, V'Rimon, Eretz Zet Shemen, U'Dvash. Dvash means dates. Okay, the honey that comes, the juice that comes out of the dates is Dvash. Okay. So how do you know which one is first? So let's put away chita and seora, it's the cookies, the cakes, the bread, whatever, let's put it aside. Now it's going to come first. So eretz chita, u'seora ve gefen. Gefen is grapes. So why grapes are not first?
You're already done in the
gilu. Closer to the eretz.
The closest to the eretz.
Eretz chita,
eretz chita, u'seora. Gefen. Gefen is number three to the land, to the word Eretz. But look at that. In the next, the continuous of the Pasuk says, it also given to another one, Eretz Zet, Shemen Udvash. So first to the second Eretz is the Zayit. It gets first priority. What if you have something that is, let's say, second to the Eretz and second to the Eretz? Both second to the Eretz. You follow the first Eretz. First Eretz gets first priority. Okay, let's say they do, they roast it, but they bake it, some wheat, or they make like shalva. Exactly. Kabel chet. Okay? So this is the simple math. Follow the Sidur, and in the Sidur, it shows you which one first. So people usually don't put olives on the Rosh Hashanah table. But they would put dates. And they would put pomegranate. And so dates get first priority.
The olive is not sweet.
Okay. So some have a custom not to eat anything that is not sweet. Right. By the way, be very careful. Don't wish anybody. Yeah, I wish you a sweet year like a honey. יהיה לכם שנה מתוקה כדבש.
Only sweet.
Sweet. Not sweet, like honey. Why? Because you're limiting it. Only for honey. There's things that are sweeter than honey. Not sweet.
Agave.
מה? אגאווה, מה זה אגאווה? אה, זה הפאודר. סירופ. לא, יש גם פאודר, אגאווה, לא?
הוא כותב שם שלא להגיד, שנה מתוקה כתבה שלנו, יש יותר מתוק
כתבה. יש יותר מתוק כתבה. הוא
כותב שם בחסר.
אוקיי. פשטייס. נהגו לאכול בשני הלילות של ראש השנה מיני מאכלים. וסימן טוב לכל השנה. The idea behind it is the rabbi, what the rabbis wanted to do. The rabbi wants to say, listen, this is a very, it's a time מסוגל, it's a time of will. שעת רצון. This is the time to say, many time יהי רצון. So they brought this idea with saying blessings over fruits. It's actually we're wishing יהי רצון. There's actually one blessing we're doing, no more than that. Why? Because the custom is to do kiddush, washing the hands, beracha, hamotzi beracha, and now we eat the fruit or the vegetables. Vegetables, you don't say any beracha. You do only beracha one time ha'etz. Who gets first priority? The date, unless you have zetim, olive. God will get the first priority. Some have customary not to eat zeytin because they either sour or they spicy. לא נכון, אני אוכיח לך.
זית זה לא...
אתה יכול לברך על זית בתוך סעודה?
סליחה, סליחה, שאלת שאלה טובה. יש לי גוד קוושן.
עכשיו אתה אוכל...
I gave you מלפפון.
אתה אוכל פיתה עם שניצל.
לא, אני לא אוהב זה משמין, אבל יש מלפפון למשל. You chop... cucumber, okay? You want to take a piece and eat during the meal. You say bracha?
No.
No, in which case you will say bracha? You will say bracha. You didn't eat at the time. You did a mochi and you'll have to say bracha over the cucumber. No, no, no. Right. When? As an appetizer. A dessert, I'm sorry. For a dessert. When it comes as a dessert, you say bracha over it. Now here, you're dedicating this special fruit. Shnia, you're doing special fruit. You do special fruit. Listen to me. For the blessing. Some poskim, some aharonim, hold, like you, what you're saying, it's a problem. Because normally, we don't say bracha over olive. It's something you eat, part of a salad, part of fruit. So I said, don't bring it at all. Right. This is what you said, I said before, you won't see olive on the table.
Indeed.
Some have the custom to do the kiddush and then the brachot. Ha'etz, adama, they want to do the brachot. It's not recommended custom. You can do it, but it's not recommended. No, before amotzi. In between kiddush and...
No, what is recommended? Before amotzi or after amotzi?
Before amotzi is not recommended. Why? Because you put yourself in the place that you don't know if you have to do bracha harona. I did the amount, the kazait, kabeitza, what was it? So, right. According to all opinion, there's no problem. After hamotzi, you do one haetz and then wishes. Yiratzon, you can make up whatever you want. The way you gezer, Hashem, gzor alenu, gzerot tovot. Make up as you go, no problem. אתה לא יכול. He gets first priority. No. He can't.
אבל...
Only the Rambam פסקן חביב. לא, only the Rambam פסקן חביב. לא. לא, only the Rambam פסקן חביב. הלכה, חביב, מי what you like better. Like you say, you have apple.
אני חושב.
Whatever you like more.
זה מה שזכור לי, שגם השולחן ערוך מביא.
כן, אני גם ראיתי את זה. שכתב שם, שאם יש... If the guy, if there's even though, okay, like he says, okay, this is from the seven species, okay, so I guess...
Seven species get... Okay, okay.
So if the guy...
Okay, show it to me, because I didn't see it.
...wants to bless on this one.
No. Nifsak la'alacha, it's paskin la'alacha, שחביב, yes, but if you have seven, about שבעת המינים, it takes first priority. This is Chacham Avadia paskin too, even if you have something that you like. You like banana now. I like banana. I don't like dates. I want the dates to eat later. He said, nevertheless, do the tamar now. Because it's hashivut. What if I don't like at all tamar? It's a different story. You don't have to eat something you don't like. You just don't like it now. Pashteis?
הרב, אני מבין אם עכשיו יש לך בן אדם מברך על העץ, יש קשיו ויש זית או תמר או תאנה, אני מבין את החשיבות של הפריוריטי. מן הסתם זה אחד משבעת המינים וזה בכלל לא כזה. אבל בתוך השבעת המינים, לקחת משהו מהשולחן שמופיע במשפט יותר קרוב.
כן, כן, יש לו, גם שם יש סדר חשיבות. זה כמו יודע, זה פמילי. Who cares who is the father, who is the mother, who is the son, who is the daughter? They're all one family. No, it's חשיבות. Who is the head of the household? Who is the...
אז מלכתחיל הם לא מביאים את שתי המינים האלה בפרונט of the table.
כן, we do.
And לא, מלכתחיל הם לא מכנסים למחלוקת הזאת.
לא, מביאים. יש סדר, מה בא לדעת את הסדר? זה לא בעיה. Just follow the סידור. I want to finish just by saying something very important. And also the Pele Yoret brings that on the Ot Bet, I think, Beracha. He says, people don't know why they're blessing their children, the wife, the family, and the Beracha doesn't go through. It's not accepted. Why? Because they do a fatal mistake, a big mistake. What's the big mistake? Most of the people do that. What they do, בוא תבדוק אחר כך, שב עכשיו. בסדר, צדיק. תודה. עכשיו, עכשיו תקשיב לשיעור. So, אחר כך תקרא את זה. אוקיי. אז אני רוצה לסגור את זה. אז מה אמרנו? What did we say? כן, the blessing. What's the big problem? Someone many years ago lost his priesthood because of that.
What?
Priesthood. את הכהונה שלו. Many years ago, before the people of Israel even got the Torah, there was a very important persona. His name was Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu came back from a war. And the war was against four kings. The four kings beat the five kings. They were very strong. He was able to save Lot. So he went all the way back to Shalem. Shalem is Yerushalayim. He called it Yirah, place of Yirah. Fear and Shalem, Yero, Yira, Yira, Yero, Shalem, together with Shalem. Anyways, who came out to greet him? A very old person. The son of Noah. His name was Shem. And he came out to greet Avraham Avinu. Nevertheless, he killed his own descendants. And he says, Baruch Avraham. And Baruch Hashem. He blessed Avraham. And he blessed the God of Avraham. And Avraham got upset. He says, "Makdimin kivod aved lekivod rabbo." He says, "You greet the servant before you greet the king. This is not appropriate." And he says, "Vehu kohen le'al elyon ba'itayi ba'itayi." That day, he was kohen, but not his descendants. Hashem moved this priesthood honor from Shem because of that mistake. To Avraham Avinu. Avraham to Yitzchak, Yitzchak to Yaakov, Yaakov to Levi, Levi to Aharon, and all the descendants of Aharon from ever since to now. Why? Avraham Avinu taught a great lesson. Anytime you want to greet someone, greet Hashem first. Look at Tefillat Amida. Tefillat Amida, greeting to God first. You are the Almighty, everything comes from you. We greet God, and then you greet person, people. מחיי מתים, כזה, אז אני אסף אנשים, רפאנו.
זה
what you're asking. What you're doing here is you take your son, he says, Hashem will bless you. And you should have so and so. So who's get the beracha? The kid. From whom? Say, oh, you use me for beracha. What about me? No. So what you should do? Always start with saying, that's what I'm trying to do every Shabbat. What I'm doing? Yehi Shem Hashem Evorach. I bless Hashem first. And then give beracha. There's a question people do l'chaim. So what they do? L'chaim, l'chaim for this and that. L'chaim for this, blessing, parnasa, children, talmidei chachamim, and l'chaim, l'chaim. Baruch, adam, she'akol niya bidvaro, or a gefen, or whatever. Okay, if it's a whiskey, she'akol, if a gefen is wine. Big mistake. Big mistake. What does you do? Abotai, baruch, adam, boreh, pri a gefen, or she'akol, if it's a whiskey. You drink, then I want to say l'chaim, and first you bless Hashem, then for your own needs. This is also the order in Rosh Hashanah. You don't say beracha, yihi ratzon, you do first, or the beracha first? Beracha first, you taste, and then do yihi ratzon. And this is what it says also in the book of Rabbi Elazar Papo, Pele Yoetz. It says, this is why people don't know this very simple thing, that they're blessing themselves, and then they remember there is God. And by the way, Hashem too. Baruch Ata Hashem for the fruit and fruit. And okay? So on Rosh Hashanah itself, you must do beracha, and then the greetings. Is that clear? Understand? No, start from now. Fix it. Oh, first boy, I bet you, you'll forget. The next lechaim you do, you probably will forget. But I hope you won't. Always before.
לא דיברתי על זה, דיברתי על הברכות של הסימנים.
על הסימנים עצמם?
לא, דיברתי, אני רוצה לשאול אם עכשיו, בן אדם עכשיו צריך לעשות, נגיד, סתם דוגמה, בורא פרי העץ, אוקיי? בן אדם יכול לעשות בורא פרי העץ, ואז לעבור לאדמה ולעבור לשהכל, ואז לעשות את הכל איזה...
הירצונים? הירצונים? כן. הירצונים זה custom, you can do it even later, there's no problem. I tell you more than that, people can't stand ahead of...
צריך ללכת לפי סדר מסוים?
People can't stand head of fish on the table. Oh, it's staring at me, the head of a sheep. It's staring, I can't stand it. I hear it all the time. You know, my wife, you put the head of it, you put your head over there. So what we do? We have a trick. We're using a candy made out of, came from New York, we bought it from Bingo. Bingo is the ocean. I don't know. We bought candies, fish shape like. And that's it. עושה ברכה, יהי רצון, ובי like a head, multiply like fish, we had another tail, so far and so on. Okay? There is no mitzvah to eat something you discuss with. It's disgusting for you. You don't have to do it. You don't have to suffer. For example, there's a mitzvah to eat meat on Shabbat?
No.
No? When there's a mitzvah to eat meat? On Yom Tov. Okay. En simcha ela, there's joy eating, eat and wine. I don't like meat. What if I don't like meat? Halacha says you need to eat meat, especially fall meat, right? From a cow. Red meat, let's put it that way, red meat. Right, if you suffer from it, of course not. You don't have to. People, when they hear barbecue, they get excited. People are excited if I'm eating a barbecue. No, it's also
not.
שמחת בחגיך, אין שמחה אלא ביין. פשטייס? אז, so, if you don't have special preference, follow the order of the seven species. If you have preference, I don't like meat, you don't have to force yourself. Right? Especially not on Shabbat. Shabbat is onig. I will let's stop here. Any questions? Any questions?
No.
You clear about what we said? We've learned many things today. So let's focus on doing the right blessing, the right way. Always greet and bless Hashem first. And then your children, your needs, whatever you need. Okay? The order of the berachot, sorry, and the yiratzonim after blessing. Some do mistake. I saw it many times. Yehi ratzon she so and so and so. Baruch adam borei pri ha'etz and they eat. No. You eat. You say bracha over the date. You eat. Take a piece. And then after you swallow, say the yehi ratzon. You have enough time to say as many yehi ratzon as you want. What if people says, why are you saying borei pri ha'etz? I want to say borei pri ha'etz too. Why only says yehi ratzon? You have 20 people. All of them can say Borei Pri HaEtz אין יהי רצון. No problem at all. It's even recommended. אז מני ברכות, אין אמנים.
אז רגע, אפשר לעשות דבר? Sometimes it can be דרך הציבור.
Depends which house. Some people don't stand it.
למה שאלתי את זה? כי בן אדם פתאום יכול לאכול איזה משהו שהוא בתור את אדמה, והוא לא ברך הזה.
אוקיי.
אז ככה הוא יודע שעובר מעץ לאדמה, לשעקול, ואז...
עושה ברכה.
שחיינו tonight. שחיינו tonight, שחיינו.
עדיף לעשות את
הברכות. ואז כולם עושים איתו את
השחיינו.
אי רצון. They can do one אי רצון, everybody can do it by their own. Yes. The second night, because it's debates, it's better to bring something new to the table, fruit.
Can you say
Shechianu
on a new fruit at lunchtime, or not?
Absolutely. You can. It's still one day. The best is to do on the Kiddush at the evening, because that's you mark the start of the day, the beginning of the day.
To do the second night.
Second night, at night, at evening. Right. It's better than the morning.
You don't need a fruit.
No. Anyway. The debate is if this is considered one day. It's called Yom Arichta. Or it's 2 days. So the Rambam Paskin, this is 2 days.
And any fruit can be
Shechianu,
because it's brand new, the year. Doesn't matter if you had it.
No. It followed the season of the fruit. Not the new
year.
And if you didn't eat from it, if you eat watermelon yesterday, it doesn't become new to you the day after.
Just because the year is new.
Right, no. It's the season of the fruit.
Huh?
Limon. But absolutely.
יכול.
Because you didn't eat, it's a juice.
כל כמה זמן פרי נחשב, כל כמה זמן אפשר שחיינו פרי חדש?
Once a year.
Once a year.
By the for the season.
שמעתי שהרב בן ציון מוצפי, שמעתי באחד השיעורים שלו, שמעתי היום אתמול, הוא אמר שמה שאמרת עכשיו על שאתה מברך את הקדוש ברוך הוא, ביום השביעי שבת וינפש, והוא אמר שיש דעה שאומרת שראש שתשרה זה החודש השביעי.
מה זה יש דעה? יש דעה כזו.
בסדר, יש דעה שהוא ראשון, לא שהשביעי.
אוקיי.
אבל בכל מקרה הזה...
זה לא דעה, זה כתוב את זה בתורה. בסדר. ראשון לחודש השביעי, מכל הקודש שלכם,
אוקיי. Can I just stop the broadcasting? Okay. Say it in English, people. I have viewers. I have like 10 viewers now.
So watching basically, English. So Tishrei is the 7th month of the year by some
by the Torah calendar.
Okay. So when you say in the Yir Atzon, Yir Atzon, Mefanecha Hashem Elokeinu Velokei Avoten, Yir Atzon, Mefanecha Hashem Elokeinu Velokei Avoten, the 7th word is the bracha. Is what you.
Chazak Baruch. רבי חנה בן הקשי אומר, עשה הקדוש ברוך הוא זכו ישראל לפי חייב בלם תורה ומצוות, שנאמר, אדוני חפץ למה עשית פה, יגדיל תורה וידי. איזה הלכה? כך תקרא אתה.
You need to say 7 words.
The 7th word is the...